In this video, we are going to learn how to write an algorithm and flowchart for a loop. Loop means repetition of work. Means if we want to execute a statement again and again, then that statement has to be written inside a loop. For example, if I ask you to display your name 10 times, then the printing of your name has to be occur in a loop. So let's start the concept of loop by taking one example. The task is we have to display numbers from 1 to 100. Now we are writing the algorithm for the same. Step 1, start. Step 2, we want to display number from 1 to 100, so we are initializing the number by 1. So initialize a variable a by 1. Now step 3, we have to check the condition whether the value of a has reached 100 or not. If it is reached 100, then it is required to be stopped. So we are checking if value of a is less than equal to 100, then step 4, print the value of a. So we have initialized the variable a by 1. 1 is less than 100, this condition is true, so it will print the value of a. Now we have to increase the value of a by 1 so that it will become 2. Step 5, a equal to a plus 1, then the value of a will become 2. Now after that again we have to print a, so from here to here again we have to move, because value of a become 2, again we are checking the value of a is less than equal to 100 or not. If it is less than equal to 100, then again we will print a. So step 6, move to step 3. If this condition is false, step 7, stop. If this condition is false, then it will be stopped. Let us transform this in the flowchart. Start. After that we are using processing box in which we are initializing a variable by 1. After that we are checking the condition if value of a is less than equal to 100. If this condition is true, then we are using the display box, print a. Again, we are increasing the value of a by 1. So we have used processing a box a equal to a plus 1. And after that, we are moving to this point again. So if it is 1, again 2, 2 less than equal to 100, print 2, 3, 3 less than equal to 100, print 3, 4 less, like that. So it will continue till this condition is false. Or once this condition is false, we are going to stop the execution. In this way, we can draw a flowchart of a loop.